That's the lobby. That's the church nerd speak for lobby. We'll catch up one of these days with the lingo. But while they're doing that, just wanted to say a brief word of welcome. We're going to have like 75 chairs now. This is great. Just a brief word of welcome. We're glad you're here to worship with us this day. We do have an opportunity to see our kids in the Christmas program this morning. I'm in the Disney universe today. I'm not in Star Wars, but you know. At least in the same realm of heroes, right? And we're going to hear about some heroes and a Star Trek this morning with our children's program. So we're excited for that. Couple of announcements real quick. Right after our service today, our worship service, we are selling Christmas cookies. Several people brought in cookies, lots and lots of cookies. And they will, you guys with the chairs, you can just put them out there, just line them up. Would be great. We'll be selling Christmas cookies, and the proceeds will go to our youth ministry. We start building funds years ahead for some major trips that they'll be taking. In fact, 3 years from now, heading out to Minnesota to go on a youth gathering trip, which will bring about 30,000 or maybe more youth and adults together for a wonderful faith formation experience. But we appreciate any participation in the cookie sale. That will be a big help for us. Thank you all for grabbing the chairs. I appreciate it. This is the third Sunday in the season of Advent for us. And so we march closer towards the day of celebration of Christmas. We wait, and we wait with hope and joy. Even though things might seem dark and dreary for some, we expect Christ's coming to be joyful for us. We have this great program today, and many thanks to those who helped to organize, get it together. We will share the piece in just a moment, but I just want to check and see if there's any other special announcements for the day. Anything else?
So, this afternoon at 3 o'clock at our my house is the Life Christmas Party. It's all the information on what people are bringing, because it is very specific based on age and what grade you're in and stuff like that, is all on the Life Facebook page. If you need to know how to get to my house, please don't hesitate to see me and Happy afterwards, and we'll get you there, or Allie, or, yeah, anyways.
All right, so youth Christmas party.
Yeah.
3 o'clock, 3 or 3?
3 or 3.
Excellent. All right. Well, we're going to continue our service with lighting of our Advent candle, of our Advent wreath. So if you would come on forward, and we will have a special prayer as we continue our march in this march forward in this season of Advent.
Let us pray. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, ruler of the universe. Your prophets spoke of a day when the desert would blossom and waters would break forth in the wilderness. Bless us as we light the candles on this wreath. Strengthen our hearts as we prepare for the coming of the Lord. May He give water to all who thirst, for He is our light and our salvation. Blessed be God forever. Amen.
I invite you to rise as you are able.
Peace of Christ be with you always. Let us share God's peace with one another.
Let us share a sign of God's peace.
Peace.
Started.
galaxy far, far away. Well, not a galaxy far, far away. A long time ago in a land sort of far away. It's a period of unrest for the people of God. The empire of King Herod, backed by the Roman oppressors, is a dark force in the land of Judah. Who can bring light into this dark situation? Who can bring light into the even deeper darkness in our lives? None from the East believe they have found the answer. These men, who some call wise, some call magi, some say they were kings. They saw a new light in the night sky. They followed this star, believing that it will lead them to another light, a light for all humankind, the light of the world, the one sent of God. It's the light spoken in the book of John.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Out him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life. The life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and darkness has not overcome it. So tonight we invite you to imagine with us as we go on a journey with the Magi following the star. Although you've never met these, then you might find these wise men seem quite familiar, and yet there's something from out of this world.
A long, long time ago, in a country far, far away, there lived three men. By all accounts, they were very wise men. They had it all, strength, courage, smarts. You could say they were quite a force to be reckoned with. These men, wise men, were least
watchers, even before that comes from stargazing.
Only one can know me.
There's only one star I see, and that's you.
And, of course, the little guy, Yoma.
And it's 6 a.m. Call you back later, I will.
For all of their strength, courage, and smarts, there was one area where these wise men weren't so wise at all.
That's not very nice to say.
Offended I am.
Are you going to chime in here on anyone?
What?
Oh yeah,
how dare you?
Anyway, these men were wise in every way but one, where they put their hope. We all put our hope in something, and unless we're putting our hope in God, we're putting it in the wrong place.
Who's the best wise man? You are. You're the best wise man.
Any situation you face, only one trusts in himself to figure it out. Yoma put his faith in others.
Yo, Ma. It's me, Yoma.
Whenever trouble arose, Yoma relied on his family and friends to bail him out.
Lost my job, I did. Money for groceries, I need.
What about him? What's he putting his hope in?
I put my hope in science. You have put your hope in something that can never change. Family and friends can live this down.
Giving me money you want? Cutting me off you are.
And we can't hope in ourselves either.
Why not? I never change.
Are you kidding me, being No, I put what I can feel, taste, feel, and touch. I put my hope in science, something that never changes.
God is the only one that never changes.
Not true. Not true. Every time I look into the telescope, it's the same stars, same moons, same constellations. But I'm not going to look into the telescope and see it in a whole another star.
What is it?
It can't be. A new star. All hope is lost.
All hope is lost.
Lost all hope is.
Hope is not lost, you just have to put your hope in the right place. Don't hope in you, hope in the one who made you. Don't hope in your family, hope in the one who gave you your family. Don't hope in the stars, hope in the one who fixes the stars in the sky, God.
She's right, I'm going to put my hope in God. I'm putting the mirror away.
Stop asking for a light from my father, I will.
I'm going to follow that star.
Why?
God put a whole new star in the sky. I'm trusting and hoping in him to show you that I'm following that star.
Yeah.
star trip begins with hope. The Magi follows the star with belief, with the hope that it would lead them to a new king. But this journey of hope began many years before that. Centuries, the faithful have put their trust in God to send a savior to deliver them from their enemies, the Assyrians, the Babylonians, and the Romans. God was preparing something greater. He was sending Jesus into the world, the only one who could transform sin and death into new life.
God spoke through prophets like Isaiah, Jeremiah, and Ruth. These prophets told the people, have hope, God has not forgotten us. The Messiah, the Savior, is come. One of the messages delivered by the prophet Michael was have a crucial role to play in the journey of the Magi hundreds of years ago.
Micah 5, 1 through 5a. Marshal the troops now. City of troops for a siege is laid against them. They will strike Israel's ruler on their cheek with a lie. But you, Bethlehem, of Ephrathah, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me. One who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from old, from ancient times.
Therefore, Israel will be abandoned until the time when she who is in labor bears a son, and the rest of the brothers return to join the Israelites. He will stand and shepherd his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And
God put the star in the sky to send the arrival of the new king.
What's wrong with you?
Nothing. I'm excited.
Exactly. We're dirty, we're tired, we've been fighting these camels forever.
How sore my bottom is.
Wait a minute. What about when we're going to meet the new king?
Oh, I don't feel like we're ever going to get there. Maybe there is no point in the journey. Maybe there is no king. I want to go home.
Me too. Oh, or to me.
Stop, wait a minute, you two. Look up there. What do you see?
A star!
The same star we've been following forever!
It's not just a star.
It's not?
It's a promise. A shining, shimmering promise that God put in the sky to signal the arrival of the new king. A promise that he would send us to the new king. Now you can go back. No. You can go back if you like, but I'm going to keep following that star.
You're right. I'm in.
And Yoma is awesome.
Great!
But can we stop at McDonald's first? I'm hungry.
Thank you.
three wise men and have been traveling for some time following a new star that God had placed in the sky. Eventually, they came to Judea and to the capital city of Jerusalem. The temple of God was in Jerusalem. The king's palace was in Jerusalem. Surely, this would be the perfect place to find the new one king that God had promised. The current king of the land was a man named Herod.
Savior, Herod ran away from the light and the throat of the darkness.
Matthew 2, 1-8. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all of Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people, chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. And at Bethlehem in Judea, they replied, "For this is what the prophet has written:
But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the boys of Judah, for as you will come in, the Lord who will shepherd my people Israel." Then King Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from the day exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I may go to him."
This is him, the newborn king,
the only one sent from God.
Savior he is.
To the king. I give the peerless gold.
To the Savior, I give the finest frankincense.
That's so. What is frankincense?
That's a spice, very expensive.
You should have.
A gift to Jesus, I bring myrrh, I offer.
A pearl.
Choicest spice, mothers.
I am so overwhelmed. You've traveled so far. You've given the best that you have to offer. Why would you do all this?
But we have given Disney to compare what God has given.
His greatest gift ever, his son, Jesus.
Gave his best God did.
Now give the best to him, we will. Now I'm doing it.
This Christmas may you receive the three gifts that God has given us. Joy, peace, and salvation from his son, Jesus Christ. If someone asks us to list the gifts in the store of Christmas, we will likely answer with gold, frankincense, and myrrh. These are expensive and precious gifts, especially valuable to poor families such as Mary and Joseph. These gifts were the best that the Magi had to give, but they don't compare to the best gift in the Christmas story. That is the gift that God gave us in Jesus. God loved the world so much that he gave his only son. Whoever believes in him receives the gift of eternal life. Matthew 2:9-12. After they had heard the king, they were on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose was ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down to worship him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream to not be left in the mirror, they turned and went to their mother Mary. Jesus' birth in that tiny town of Bethlehem was the beginning of a much bigger story. It's the story of a preacher who traveled the countryside healing the sick, performing miracles, and revealing the mysteries of the kingdom of God. It's the story of how the Lamb overcame the power of sin. It's the story of God taking our flesh and standing beside us all. It's the story of God's Son being hung on the cross, dying and being resurrected. It's the story of how God turned an instrument of death and torture into a symbol of hope and life. It's the story of how we can experience forgiveness and peace through Jesus. This is the journey of faith in Jesus. God has put the star in the night sky for us. And during
Cheryl Herberg, Amy, Deanna, Melissa, Jeanette Walker, who made our ornaments, the kids that helped out, Dylan and Ainsley, and Althea and Violet and Abby Walker. Of course, the band did an awesome job. They stepped in and helped us quite a bit. So they did an awesome job. If everybody can give them a round of applause. Practices and helping them work through their lines, and then finally the kids. They did awesome.
Well, thank you to our leaders and our young ones for giving us our gospel stories today. There we go. Good job, everybody. Reminded us that God has moved into the neighborhood, that God has come to be with us in the flesh. And not only through the gift of baptism do we sense and touch and experience God with us, we also experience God in the meal together as one. We remember on the night in which he was betrayed that our Lord Jesus took bread, he gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks and he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." And now let us us boldly pray as our Savior has taught us to pray. We pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed
be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Jesus is coming to this world, and we await his coming. And now we partake in this meal to remind us of how close God is to us. You may be seated. All are welcome at this table. You will receive communion by receiving a piece of bread, and you may dip it into the chalice. There is both wine and grape juice in the chalices. You may ask your server at the time you commune, which is which. And if you do not receive communion, we invite you to come forward for a blessing.
Thank you.
Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
And now may God direct your ways in peace, make you abound in love for one another and for all, and strengthen your hearts until the coming of our Lord Jesus. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever.
Amen.
And just a reminder before we sing our last song, take a lap down at the sanctuary, get your 10 bucks ready, buy some cookies, have some yummies for this afternoon and for the rest of the holiday season or however long they'll last in your house. Thanks again to all who helped. Y'all have a good afternoon.